For some of you out there, this is going to be, without a doubt, the most useful plugin for your live streams. I'm of course talking about NVIDIA RTX Voice, a new plugin built by NVIDIA that uses AI technology to remove distracting background noises from your live streams. Things like the noisy clicks from your mechanical keyboard, or maybe it's road noise or an air conditioner, or just your neighbors doing their third workout of the day. In this video, we're gonna be demonstrating exactly how well it works by simulating some of these background noises so you can really see how much of an effect it has. A couple of notes before we get started though, you do need to have an NVIDIA GPU. It has been specifically built for RTX cards, but I've seen that there are some workarounds that people have managed to put together to get it working with older 10 series and before cards. Also, although I'll be going through in this video how to set it up for OBS Studio, as well as some other streaming software, this can be used system-wide, so you can use it in Discord, you could use it in Zoom or Skype, conferencing calls. I think really the reason that NVIDIA have put this out now is because of this whole COVID situation, and they know a lot of people are working from home and need this feature. Now, although the software is currently in beta, it's been performing super well for me the last couple of days, so I'd love to show you some examples. Let's dive in. Okay, so test time. Now, you've probably seen some of the clips go viral across the internet of people doing this with things like leaf blowers and really testing RTX Voice in some really strange situations. But I want to be a little bit more realistic with my tests and actually apply some background noise that you guys are probably experiencing for your live stream. So we're gonna do three different tests here. Firstly, we're gonna do a keyboard typing test, typing on a mechanical keyboard, seeing how much of a difference it makes with RTX Voice on and off. We're going to be doing a test with some background noise of like an air conditioner. So this can simulate either a computer fan being quite noisy next to your microphone or an air conditioner as we go into summer. And then finally, we're going to do one with a bit of background traffic noise in case you live next to an intersection. Now, with all these tests, I would highly recommend using a good pair of headphones or studio monitors to make sure that you can hear the differences in both my voice as we enable and disable RTX Voice and also in the background noise reduction. So put the cans on. So actually, I lied. The first test that we're gonna do isn't going to involve any background noise altogether. I'm just gonna test what my voice sounds like with and without RTX Voice turned on and off, because that's kind of important. I wanna know how much it affects the actual tone of my voice, because usually these noise suppression plugins, they kind of make your voice sound very tinny, and I'm keen to hear the results. So this is obviously me speaking without RTX Voice on. I'm going to enable it now at 100%. And this is now me talking with RTX Voice turned on, and I'm keen to hear how this sounds differently. Okay, so just listen to that back, and it really doesn't sound like there's much difference between RTX on and RTX off, which is kind of amazing, actually, because usually these noise suppression plugins that you do after the fact in post, they make your voice sound very tinny. So it's good to know that when there isn't really much background noise, RTX Voice isn't really affecting your voice that much. The next test is a bit more difficult, and that is a mechanical keyboard test. So I'm gonna be doing some typing on my mechanical keyboard, firstly with RTX Voice off. So I'll start typing now, and hopefully whilst I'm talking, you can hear some of that keyboard sound coming back into my microphone. If I stop speaking, but keep typing, you should be able to hear that faintly in the background. Let's now enable RTX Voice and see how it affects it. So RTX Voice is now enabled. I'm going to start typing in 3, 2, 1, starting typing. And it seems like when I'm not speaking, it's not picking up anything, but I'd be keen to hear how good of a job it does when I'm speaking and typing at the same time. So listening back to that, there definitely was a difference in the tone of my voice, which is obviously expected, but it was nowhere near as bad as I thought it would be. And it clearly did a very good job of removing the background noise of me typing, especially when I wasn't speaking. There was still some faint rumblings of my typing when I was speaking, which is obviously a harder test, but I was really quite impressed, especially when I wasn't talking. You couldn't hear the keyboard noise at all. For the next test, I'm going to be playing the sound of an air conditioner through my speakers here to see exactly how much that affects it, because I think this is really a very common use case, especially for people living in hotter countries than the UK. As we go into summer, people want to be able to put their air conditioners on, but usually the advice has been, whilst you're streaming, turn it off, just be hot, because the voice is so much more important if you wanted to grow your live stream. But with RTX Voice, will it make a difference? Let's see. So firstly, with RTX Voice turned off, I'm gonna play the air conditioner. Now I've got that pretty loud. That's distracting to me, even with headphones on. I can see in the waveform that that is definitely being picked up when I don't have RTX Voice on. So let me now enable RTX Voice. Certainly when I'm not speaking, you can't see that appearing on the waveform at all. I'd be keen again to listen back to exactly how it sounds whilst I am talking, if you can still hear the background noise of the air conditioner fan. So that I thought was really impressive. It seems like the white noise kind of examples of an air conditioner or a computer fan really perform as well with RTX Voice. I think it did better than the keyboard test personally. My voice didn't sound quite as unnatural, and it did a better job of removing it whilst I was talking. So the final example we're going to do is some traffic noise. So if you live next to a busy road with cars going past the whole time and people talking, this is aimed to simulate that. So firstly, with RTX Voice off, and now me speaking over the noise so you can see exactly how that affects it. And next, we will now enable RTX Voice. And now this is me speaking over the traffic noise with RTX Voice turned on. So from my point of view, if you're dealing with any of these kind of sounds, like loud mechanical keyboard or some traffic noise or some white noise from a computer fan or an air conditioner, you should really consider downloading RTX Voice if you have the capable hardware. It does come with some performance hit. I didn't go really into detail here. I just ran a few examples with it on and off in certain games, and I noticed maybe a 5% difference in the frame rate that I was getting. I wasn't dropping any frames in OBS. I wasn't having any kind of render lag because it uses a different part of the chip. It's not using the NVENC encoder, but I was getting slightly reduced frame rate. So if you're already maxing out your frame rate and really pushing your computer to the limits, you may want to consider exactly how much of this suppression you use. If you want to install RTX Voice and use it in your own live streams or in Discord or anything like that, it's super simple to install. Just head to the website I've linked in the description, download and install the program as you would with any other, and then choose your input device in the software. Next, open up whatever application you want to use RTX Voice in, and just change your input or microphone device to NVIDIA RTX Voice. So my overall suggestions are absolutely you should be using RTX Voice if you have any kind of background noise that you want to remove for your live streams and you have the compatible hardware. It's still in its beta, so it's going to be improving over time, but why not just download it, give it a go, see how it performs. Does it affect your computer that much? Can you still get high frame rates whilst running it? And how much does it reduce the background noise for you? Hopefully this video has been helpful for you guys. I've got a whole bunch of people in the Discord who are running tests on their setups with RTX Voice. So do jump in there if you want to join that conversation, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace. How it deals with it. So to start with RTX Voice off, and now I'm going to enable RTX Voice.